Hallelujah. Good day. God bless you. It's a day we pray for families, we pray for children all over the world, whether your children, whether biological or spiritual. We're going to be praying for them, and I have a word for you that it is our responsibility to train up these children to becoming who God wants them to be. I saw that there were some children that are destined for greatness, but there has been obstacles in their ways, and the people around them have ignored prayer because of the kind of things you see them involved in, and my heart was just like weeping. And this day, I just want every woman, wherever you are, whether you have had your own or not, to join us in prayer to recover them, to take their positions, to take their positions, to be where God wants them to be, to occupy till He comes. Those that are called into the ministry, those that are called to become governors, mayors, congressmen and women, called to become president, called in to become CEOs, who have derailed because the enemy knows where they are heading to, and the enemy is not happy. We recover you all in the name of Jesus. Your eyes be open to see what God is showing you, where you are to be and where you are now, so that you take your position in the name of Jesus. Brethren, it's a beautiful day, as I said. I bring you good news from Temple Rebuilders Ministries. And my name is Christy Ogwabunwa. I stepped into this position of reading the daily devotional because I was tired of calling all the people that are supposed to be doing their job. And since I started doing it, I saw that God has been flowing through me. I've been that type of person that wants to hide myself so that I will not be burdened, but then there are times that and seasons God wants to use us. I am just a vessel, such a time as this, and nothing more. So do not look at me, look at the God that have called me. When you have a problem, go to God and God will solve that problem for you. Remember, you can check us out on YouTube, Temple Rebuilders Ministries. You can also go to our Facebook. You can also call us on HoustonTRM@gmail.com. We have prayer for children every Tuesday in the church. We call it prayer breakfast. Join us. Amen. Today we are reading 1 Kings 3, chapter 3, verse 9. And we are on the second part of pray for discernment. Give to your servant an understanding heart that I may discern between good and evil. That was the prayer of Solomon. Let's read it in full. And when we read it, we will come back to pray. It says, give therefore your servant an understanding heart to judge your people, that I may discern between good and evil. For who is able to judge these your great people? Verse 10 says, the speech pleased the Lord, that Solomon had asked him this. Solomon, a younger person. Solomon, stepping into the father's shoe. Solomon defeating Absalom. But remember, there was a role the mother played. Without the mother going to the king when the King David was sick to say, you promised me that my own child will step into your position. But now Absalom had declared himself king. And king say for what? Makawai. King decided to do it in his bedroom. And Solomon was installed. And this same Solomon, because the mother brought him up well, he went to the Lord, and the Lord made him to be outstanding. Today, every child that is born by us, even the ones on the street that doesn't know God, let them recover. Come back to Jesus. Let them take their positions on this planet Earth without failing, wherever they are. Are they in the stupor, drinking and whining away their time? Are they the ones that the devil has told to come out of school because school is no good, so that they'll be doing small job, penury job? Mbano, today we recover them all in the name of Jesus. Pray for discernment. mothers, pray for discernment. Fathers, pray for discernment. Youth, pray for discernment. Every one of us, pray for discernment. You that is nephew, niece, pray for discernment. You that is a child of God, pray for discernment. You that is just singing us, pray for discernment. It works it. It makes a difference. It will take you to where you did not expect because God is in it. Because there are discernment, whether natural or spiritual. Let us read. In this, our daily devotional, it says, the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream and asked, what shall I give you? Verse 5. Solomon said, give your servant an understanding heart to judge your people that I may discern between good and evil. Verse 9. Next, we read, the speech pleased the Lord that Solomon had asked this thing. Verse 10. But God wasn't through